Back with another video. So today's video is going to be yet again another girl talk video. Today's topic is sex. Let's talk about sex. This has been a highly requested topic for me. I guess a lot of you girls look up to me in regards to a lot of things. I did get a comment, and someone actually did comment on my video and said, why do people ask you to make sexual decisions for them? That is really life-changing. And I thought, you know, I do agree. Why do people ask me to make their sexual decisions for them? I feel like the best I can do is give you advice or maybe speak from personal experience and also just let you girls know some tips that may help you guide your own decision. But I cannot make your decision for you, and I can't let my beliefs and my values be inflicted on you. I will try my best to be, you know, unbiased, because there are things that I do personally believe and hold to a virtue, but I also want to make sure that you guys make your own decisions and don't feel forced or don't feel as if somebody is holding your hand when it comes to sex and what you want to do in that regard. So this is going to be a little bit different than usual girl talks. In the beginning, I'm going to give my usual commentary about the topic. At the end, I do have some questions that you guys did ask me that I'll answer, and this will help guide basically our conversation. So let's talk about sex. This is the age of 2018. You young ladies know what sex is. People are having sex younger and younger and younger each year, okay? Each month, actually. When it came to my own personal experiences with this was something that I felt like I was not ready for at the age, and I thought I was, because it was so much peer pressure, it was so much influence. You know, if I turn on the TV right now, it's gonna be a lot of, you know, very explicit women and how they're dressed. You're gonna be talking about their men. I want to make sure that I sit up here and I say what I have to say, but I also want you ladies to listen to what I have to say and then use that in fueling you to make your own decision. I honestly would not recommend people to have sex at a young age. Now, a lot of the girls who watch me are within the high school, middle school age. That means you are anywhere from 11 years old to maybe 18 years old. Nowadays, people think, well, maybe I'm 16 or I'm 17, I'm grown. You're not grown. I'm not grown, and I'm about to be 21. And they think that sex is something that is solidified in a relationship, which is completely false. Sex is something that is a very sacred thing. And when we're young and we're women and we see boys get to do whatever they want to do sexually most times, and we see the people that we watch on TV feel as if it's just something that's free, we are often influenced to think like, okay, well, if I just do it once, or if I do it with this guy, you know, it's not that big of a deal. And it may not be that big of a deal in the regard that sex is almost like a casual conversation now, but personally within ourselves as women, yes, it is a big deal. There's a lot of things that you have to take in consideration before you make the decision to really sit up here and have sex with somebody. Number one, are they tested? Are they clean? A lot of you girls will go in and say, well, I feel like I want to have sex with this boy, but you're not even old enough to get into a car and drive yourself to the clinic to go see if he's clean and you're clean. And two, do you really love this person, and does this person love you? If I could take back my virginity, I would, and save it for a later date, because I was not in love with this person. This person was not in love with me. This person didn't really care much about me, and I only did it because it was something like a pressure. I felt pressured by this individual to kind of make him happy. Now, three is, are you doing it for the right reasons? A lot of you girls need to take into consideration what it really means for you to have sex as an individual. I get the question a lot, well, you're Nigerian, you know how we're raised, you know, do you feel as if you should be having sex knowing that we're brought up in a strict Christian household or strict Catholic household? What does it mean to you religiously? What does it mean to you sexually? What does it mean to you socially? Because you get a lot of girls being labeled as hoes, thots, smuts, sluts, that type of thing, for having sex when they're not out here really disrespecting themselves, but they made the choice to have sex. You get a lot of girls being called those same names. In addition, probably being called things like, you know, unchristian, or, you know, doesn't respect herself, all because she decided to make the decision to have sex before marriage. All of those things are very personal. They're very subjective, if you ask me. It goes along with what you believe in. But I personally have my own stance, and that's what I'm going to give to you guys now. Young girls, and I mean everybody, I mean elementary school if you're watching, middle school if you're watching, high school if you're watching, do not have sex. It is something that is just too risky. Think in the back of your mind, HIV, HPV, hepatitis B, all them DMB, all of that, okay? I think about that every single time. And it's just like, you don't want to put yourself at risk for maybe 5 to 10 minutes of whatever these little boys are giving you. Also, think about this. These little boys in high school, they really don't care about you. They don't. You may think you're going to be with them forever. You won't. Once college comes around, I've seen every strong relationship break up because of college or break up because of post high school, you know, life. You really want to sit here and give yourself to someone who you know is really here for you. And I'm not saying that it has to be someone who's going to marry you. I'm just saying it has to be someone who you know loves you, cares about you, and cherishes your body the way how they should. I personally don't think having sex in middle school or high school is a very good idea. When I think back to all of my friends, including myself, and just things that I probably heard from different girls growing up in high school, and when I hear their stories about what they went through to losing their virginity or having sex, none of the stories were like rainbows, unicorns, ice cream. None of it was like sweet stories. It all was either, you know, I just wanted to try it and I regretted it, or he pressured me to do it and then I did it and I didn't feel good about it, or I thought I was in love with him and I gave myself up to him and then shortly after he wasn't in love with me, or I went against my religious upbringing and now I feel as if I need to repent my sins and that type of thing. Sex shouldn't be something that causes you to second guess anything within your life. Yourself, your relationship, your spirituality, nothing like that. It shouldn't be something that makes you want to be like, damn, you know, maybe I shouldn't have done that, or damn, maybe, you know, I should have waited. If you feel ready, then you're ready, okay? And if you feel that guy is ready, then you're ready. But when you have any doubt in your mind that you are not ready to be sexually engaged with anybody, don't do it. It's not worth it. This might sound funny to you guys, but you young girls that are in middle school and high school, y'all don't even know what y'all are having sex with. Them little boys, y'all don't even know what y'all, that ain't nothing. Trust me. That ain't nothing. Them little boys are not nothing. There's nothing that they could do for you. And I'll tell you that. My next point is just the fact of sexual awareness. You know, what it is during a sexual intercourse session that needs to be done for both parties. This is not really to even sound funny in terms of, you know, morals and stuff like that. But let's say you make that decision to have sex, or you're desperately wanting to have sex. You have that urge, you know, you have that fire in you to start having sex. Okay. Do you know what you're doing as a girl? Yes or no? Does that guy know what he's doing as a guy? Yes or no? Do you have the proper protection as a couple? Yes or no? Does that guy know how to basically remove himself from you when it's time? Yes or no? I see time and time again many, many young girls getting pregnant. And it's not because they were honestly out here wanting a baby or whatever it is, but it was because of just carelessness and their ignorance during having sex. The guy didn't know what he was doing. You didn't know what you were doing. You guys were not fully prepared. You guys were not fully protected. And it's a very unfortunate circumstance, but it does happen. And I see a lot of girls asking me like, Chioma, I really want to have sex, or, you know, I really like this guy and he wants to have sex with me, but I'm not ready. That should be your cue to cut the guy off. If you're not ready, he's actually not ready. Because he should be ready for you. One thing about us girls is we're the ones who get our virginities taken. Of course, guys lose their virginity, but we're the ones that go through the physical pain. We're the ones that go through the emotional changes. Once you have sex and your period is a thing, now you're putting yourself at risk for pregnancy that guys don't go through. And then, of course, as a couple, you guys both have that risk of STDs and stuff like that. But as women, we really have to be very cautious. As young ladies, we have to be very cautious when it comes to sex. Respect yourself as a lady. If that's something that you feel like you want to do, at least respect yourself as a lady. Keep your personal business to yourself, keep your personal partners to yourself, and limit your partners. And I don't mean that to say there's a certain number of sexual partners you're supposed to have in life. I just mean as a young woman, please limit your partners. It looks very bad to both men and girls when you are 16 years old with 7 bodies. You're a baby yourself. There's no reason that your body count should be more than half your age. There's absolutely no reason, in my opinion. Because I know it's going to be, well, why can't girls do whatever they want to do sexually? You can, but make sure you have that type of self-control. Make sure you have that type of self-respect. Now, I don't want to share too much about me because I feel like, once again, that is a very personal thing to discuss on camera with thousands of people watching. But I do want to say, with my personal experiences, I don't recall having an experience that I can say was 100% perfect anytime. Whether it would be with a boyfriend, whether it be with someone who I was talking to, not a pleasuring experience overall. Maybe physically it was pleasuring, but the emotional side was very damaging. And I say that to say, get to know somebody before you let them penetrate you. How can you feel secure in your sexual relationship when you meet a guy, you guys talk for 2 weeks, he tells you that you're pretty, you're beautiful, and that he really likes you, and the first thing that you think to do is sex? Not only will you not have him in the long run, because I know how guys work, but you won't have yourself either, because you didn't allow yourself to get to know someone who is supposed to be doing something that's very, very sacred to your body. I want you girls to take away one thing. If you feel the urge to have sex, you need to start questioning yourself. Are you prepared? Are you mentally prepared? Are you emotionally prepared? Are you physically prepared? Is your hygiene okay? Is your health okay? Is he okay? Is he okay? Is he okay? And is he okay? You should be asking, is he okay? More than times than about yourself, because some guys will honestly take advantage of you girls who are very curious. And I remember being very curious. I just want to know, all my friends had already done it. I was like the last of the crop, honestly was. And I was just very curious. And my curiosity really led to something that really didn't end up benefiting me in the end, because I was not ready. I didn't give myself the time to really want to do something for the right reasons. So I'm gonna get into some questions that you guys asked me about sex and when I'm gonna talk about them. So someone asked me, how can you deal with the urges you get every once in a while in a positive manner? So I'm assuming what she's saying is maybe you feel the urge to, you know, wanna be sexually engaged and you're sexually aroused, but you don't wanna fully commit to actually being in a sexual circumstance. The positive manner to me would be remembering your morals, remembering why you are celibate or not actually having sex at the moment, and remember what really is important to you about your body sexually, and remembering what type of guy you're looking for to give yourself to, whether that be, you know, a person who's really into you as your boyfriend, or if you're waiting until marriage and after, or if you just want to be spiritually okay. Next question says, when would be a good time in a relationship to take it to the next step in having sex? Relationships, okay, so that means you guys have solidified something, you're in the relationship. Like I said, personally, I would wait until you're into the relationship and you guys are both consenting adults. Now by adults, I mean 18 and up. When both you and your partner have made the physical commitment to each other, you guys have made the spiritual commitment to each other, and you guys have made the verbal commitment to each other. By physical, I mean you guys have accepted each other's bodies for what they are. You guys know what it is that you've seen each other's bodies. You guys have learned to respect boundaries on each other's bodies. Spiritually, I obviously mean whatever you believe in, you guys are both on the same page and you guys are going to stay within the boundaries of that spirituality when it comes to the topic of sex. And then the verbal commitment is just the fact that you guys have both spoken on the topic. You guys know exactly what you want from each other and you guys are both consenting, again, because consent is something that you do have to have. And if you guys can pass those three things in a relationship, then I feel as if at that point you can't take it to the next level. Next question says, do you think it's the right decision to lose your virginity at the age of 17? Hell no, hell no, hell no. And I'm not that much older than 17. Let me not act like I'm 30, okay? I'm not that much older than 17. When I think of my 17-year-old self being a senior in high school, I have my whole life ahead of me. I have college ahead of me. I was starting my YouTube channel at the time. I had my business and everything ahead of me. I was on the cheerleading team. I was an honor roll student. I think of all those things and I think, why would I even want to mess up my status quo by being, you know, interrupted with the whole idea of sex? Y'all have to understand, sex is a whole different thing. It's not just I lay on my back, he gets on top of me, he goes in me. It's not just as easy as that. It's not just the physical part. You have to remember the spiritual, physical, verbal, the health, the hygiene that comes with it. It's another task. It's like another part of your life that you have to take into consideration. You have to take in consideration the medical part of it, whether you want to be on birth control, if you want to be on the shot, if you want to have the implant. That's a whole nother thing. And for us girls, we are the ones doing the preventative measures for pregnancies all the time, other than guys wearing condoms. That's all they get. We're the ones that have to do more. So that's another thing that you have to worry about. That's another thing you got to pay money from your insurance to make sure you can go even get the birth control. It's just a whole nother thing. And I think back to my 17-year-old self being young, I would have been in a whole bunch of baloney. At the beginning of 12th grade, I do remember being with one guy who I was dating at the time. That was very short-lived because soon after I found out he cheated within like 2 or 3 months. I was very hurt. I had to go and endure the physical part of, you know, giving myself to someone and them letting me down. The emotional part of, you know, being hurt and feeling like I was used. I had to go ahead and endure the whole, you know, medical part of making sure, you know, okay, you're cheating. Am I clean? Now I have to go ahead and endure the whole parental part of it all. It's just too much of a burden to worry about when you're young. When you're 17, no. Even honestly, when I'm 20, I don't even think I should be worried about it. And I'm not. I'm very much not on the sex scene at this moment and haven't been for months till half a year at least. So yeah, I'm keeping it up. Next question says, how come our generation does not consider following the biblical way when it comes to this topic of sex? I can't speak for the whole generation, but I think it's just this whole influence of the sexuality of the internet and social media. When I turn on Love and Hip Hop, I see titties, I see ass, I see, you know, a lot of sexual talk, I see a lot of side girls, I see a lot of I F'd your man, I see a lot of that. When I get on Instagram, you see a lot of just sexually explicit things. So girls, young girls looking up to that, and I never realized how much an influence these type of things do have on middle school age girls, high school age girls, elementary school age girls, and how they now feel propelled to be that overtly sexual when it comes to men. So they kind of defer themselves away from the traditional biblical standpoint of things, the very Christian values that you had way back in the day where you were supposed to wait to marriage. And that kind of takes a backseat now in this day and age. I think that's why we're at that point. That isn't an excuse to not hold up the whole Christianity or just the biblical standpoint of things. If that's something that you're gung-ho about, by all means, definitely be an advocate for yourself to stick through what you believe in biblically. But there is also the influence from all this social media. The next question says, if you had a child, how would you teach them about sex? That's a very good question. I always told myself, based off of my experiences, I want to be very open with my children, especially my daughters if I do have any, because I feel as if when I was young, I was too scared to talk to my mom about a lot of things regarding sex. At the time, I was a very curious individual because that's when I started going to school. I hear a lot of girls, you know, having sex. It just becomes a topic. When it comes to me, I want to be able to have that conversation with my child. One thing I want to do is I always want to be open about, you know, what age I started and what I learned from it and how much of a toll it took on me, and just be very honest, because I don't think I had that with my mom. I do now. I could tell my mom anything at all. But at that age, when I was young and I was curious, I kind of felt weird asking my mom because it's a very, you know, tiptoey subject. My dad was the one who gave me the birds and the bees talk, and that was awkward as hell. That was awkward as hell. At least I had my dad to give me a very open and honest conversation. My mom does talk about stuff like that with me as well. It wasn't until I got a little bit older where I was able to feel more comfortable. So I think at a young age, you know, when my daughter starts to enter middle school or my son starts to enter middle school, I definitely want to start having that conversation. I feel as if I will be teaching them ins and outs of everything. Everything I told you guys in this video, I might actually have them watch this video. That's exactly what I'm going to do. That's how I'm going to teach them. The next question says, why do you think people don't weigh the pros and cons before being sexual? Sex is something that is very feeling based. When your body is aroused in some way, you then feel as if you have a need to please your body. If you just ran a mile and now you're out of breath, your body's saying, okay, I need water. So you go and feed it water. If you were filing papers and you get a paper cut, your body's now bleeding, your fingers throbbing, your body's now saying, okay, we need some sort of healing ointment and band-aid to wrap it up. So you go and do that. And that's the same thing with sex. It's an urgency. You know, you get this urgency in your body that it's like, okay, I want to fulfill whatever it is my body's making me feel. So I think that it's a in the moment, heat of the moment thing with a lot of people, where they feel as if, okay, well, I feel some type of way and I like the feeling because it's a pleasuring feeling. So now I want to go and do what I need to do to have that feeling. So they think on impulse and not really on either common sense or what really makes sense to them and what really matters to them. And I think that's why people don't tend to weigh their pros and cons. But I will say, you make a mistake and you learn from it. So I'm pretty sure your second time, you know not to do that. And times after, you gain a lot more sexual experience and sexual knowledge and learn how to weigh your pros and cons. The next question says, since our society is more sexualized than ever, do you think there should be more stricter laws concerning sex in places such as school, music, or film industry? It's another good question. Do I think there should be laws? Okay, this is an opinion question. Not necessarily, because sex will always be something that you decide to do in most cases. Okay, I understand there's certain times where people are forced upon having sex. In a lot of cases, it is something that you decide to do. And I think with proper sexual health education, you will be able to know right from wrong, and you should always know how to choose right from wrong regardless of the influences around the society around us. The mood of many college students when they first get that newborn freedom is boom, sexual go time. It definitely rubbed off on me to the point where I felt as if, well, maybe I should get a boyfriend so I could start having sex, or maybe I should find someone who I should start having sex with. And I got that feeling, but I also did know right from wrong. I don't think there should be direct laws on how sex is portrayed in films, because they're not really having sex at the end of the day, and those things are done for entertainment purposes. And then also with music, my opinion is that's artist expression, even though it can be vulgar, but that's something that you depict and you have to learn from. The more wise and mature you get, you understand what those lyrics mean, and then you make, again, your own decision whether you want to engage in those things. So I don't personally think there should be laws. I think there should be definitely an implementation of required sexual education in every and all school, elementary, middle, and high school, hell, and even college. So that is it for this video. I hope you guys enjoyed. If you have any commentary on my commentary, please leave it in the comment section down below. Follow me on all of my social media networks, my Instagram, my Snapchat, and my Twitter, and I will see you guys in my next video. Bye guys. Let's talk about sex, baby. Let's talk about you and me. Let's talk about bubbles in the tub. Let's talk about making love.